And we're told now that we have video from the moment the plane crashed. Oh. We're seeing this now for the first time. Let's take a look. To re-rack that just to take another look. It's obviously very far in the distance from where this video was. You don't actually, as far as we can see, it does seem that it came down relatively in one area, or at least the biggest part of it seemed to have come down in one area.
Well, judging from the amount of flames that we saw at the point of impact, that was a large chunk, probably, and that obviously is fuel going up when you get that color smoke.
And, I mean, one's tempted to want to pause for a moment just to realize the enormity and gravity of what we're looking at. In this, the plane will have been virtually fully fueled for the Amsterdam to Kuala Lumpur flight. The missile or whatever hit it clearly didn't destroy it in mid-air. There was sufficient for the tanks to have hit the ground. And do jump in, sir, if there's something more that you can add. For the tanks to have exploded upon the ground. But what we're looking at there is...
And again, the question now, and we've heard our Nick Pitton-Walsh reporting concerns from Ukrainian officials about their ability to actually get to the crash site. This is obviously essential that officials get to the crash site, not only to get the black box, to recover any other items, as we saw with the TWA Flight 800 investigation, which again happened. This is the anniversary of that. Plane crashing. That was a very lengthy investigation where they basically reassembled the aircraft to try to determine exactly what had happened. Access to this site is going to be essential, and it's not clear at this moment exactly how that will occur.